going on, guys? I got some pretty exciting stuff here. Make sure it's clear first. I got the primary machine stealth comp on my Glock 19 build, and she's now officially a Roland Special. Yeah, I wasn't planning on this. Then primary machine dropped the bomb on me saying that they were coming out with a comp that matched perfectly with their slide work, and sure enough it does. Alright. And it matches up. The chamfering on the sides is exactly what it looks like. I mean, how they machined the slide. The dimensions is pretty spot on with the dimensions of the Glock slide. So now I'll just do a little quick holster test to show you what kind of holsters it'll fit. I got my Safariland Glock 34 holster. I took out the end just for a little bit of clearance, but I don't think you'll really need to. So let's put this bad boy in. Locks in. Maybe a little bit of wiggle. That's because of the light, but that thing is in there. Engaged. Not going anywhere. So pretty exciting stuff. Someone was saying try locking it back to the rear to do one-handed manipulations, putting it in the holster. If I could put it in the holster. Putting in the holster, doing one-handed manipulations was an issue with some other comps. And I can't do it now. So one-handed manipulation, put it in there, and then just draw. And I think it has to do with how they machine the comp onto the comp. It has because of these chamfers on the side, it helps clear the ALS system, which catches on to some of the other comps. Now we're gonna do some testing on some other holsters that I have for the Glock 19 with the light and without the light. All right, taking out the light. And got my LAS concealment appendix holster. And clears. I mean, you know, a little bit of a sticking out there, but it definitely clears. Put it in there. Alright. So that. Now we'll test it with the M3 Tactical Kydex appendix holster. This was the fabric black multicam. As you can tell, I'm in black multicam phase. But clears. Sticks out a little. This is made for a Glock 17. But put it in slowly just so you see that it actually does clear the holster just fine. No hang-ups whatsoever. So there you go. All that's needed now is a range test to see how she does firing. They claim that I won't need a lighter spring. So yeah, pretty excited. And quick question, what do you guys think? Stick with the gold or get it in black? Because, I don't know, I'm kind of on the fence. I'd rather it match everything, the gold, and this gold to match. But, I don't know, it's growing on me. So, yeah, let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Alright, so, I got my Roland Special here. And this is going to be the first few shots, and we're going to see how she does. So I just got done shooting this, put about 50 rounds through it, and man, well, all I can say is wow, this thing is a fast shooter. I'm surprised by the comp. I mean, I'm not a comp guy. I never thought I'd be a comp guy, but I carried this appendix on the way I drove with it, and it was comfortable. Primer Machine did an awesome job with this. It clears all my holsters, like I already showed you. This is the M3 holster. It sticks out a little bit, but it's fine, just to make sure it's clear. It's an awesome comp. It's not gonna make you a faster shooter. You're still gonna need to practice. You're still gonna need to know your fundamentals, your follow through and all that. Your trigger squeeze. You're still gonna need a lot of practice to be a fast shooter. So don't get this thinking you're gonna be the next John Wick, you know, doing your little pew 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 center axis relock. There you go. It's a great comp for your Roland Special. Yeah, check them out.